well, you have such a rich environment that you're, and I don't know where you are, so I haven't put which climate you're in. So if your water rats eat all those things and you've got an abundance of water rats, then you must have an abundance of fish, crustaceans, shellfish, small birds, eggs, mammals, frogs, reptiles, and in winter lots of plants, because otherwise the rats wouldn't survive. It's like a lot of people don't like having chickens. I've heard people saying they don't like chickens in the garden or tractor in the garden because they're going to eat the earthworms. Yet I find chickens create lots of earthworms, because just below the scratching depth of chickens, there are earthworms. Now, if you consider the earthworm used to give you the value of land. Land used to be priced on the number of earthworms. Now, what do earthworms eat? Earthworms eat beneficial soil bacteria. So if you're going to say that chickens eat earthworms, you better say that earthworms eat beneficial bacteria, which feed our plants. If you've got earthworms, you must have a lot of beneficial bacteria. It's good to say almost, and if you've got chickens, you're probably going to have a large amount of earthworms. It's the same with your water rats. If you've got water rats, you must have a lot of food for them. You've got a lush environment. So it's about not looking at being prejudiced about a water rat. It's been, I have a system that's so abundant in water rat food, which include fish, crustaceans, shellfish, small birds, eggs, mammals, frogs, and reptiles like you've listed, and plants in winter. It's that abundant. See, you can't pick one element out of a diverse interactive system without seeing the interactions that they particularly have. Now, I'm not saying favour water rats on their own. I'm saying that if it can support those other species. So I'm just pointing out a way to think. Now, I don't know. You might have a particular reason you've got an overabundance of water rats because you've got one particular food that's being provided for them. That might be the thing that's out of balance. But generally, there's another way to think about this. And it's like chickens with earthworms and earthworms to beneficial soil bacteria. Earthworms are an indication that you have a lot of beneficial bacteria in your soil. And we noticed every time that we mulch our gardens, mulch our chicken pens just outside of the chicken pen, just below the scratch depth, there's an abundance of earthworms. Chickens don't, they do eat earthworms, but they actually proliferate earthworms as well. The classic saying, everything gardens. We'll be right back.